aside from my youngest daughter, who incidentally is exactly the same age as my tenure of the presidency. I was named president the year she was born. So we laugh about this all the time. She knows me in no other role than being president of a university. But my other five children lived on campus. The first three all through high school, and the fourth and the fifth, the fifth was pretty much through high school, and then we moved, and the last two spent high school, and the youngest daughter most of her time off the campus. But those four, well, the five to be exact, this was their home. This campus was their home, and it gave them also a very, very important aspect of growing up. This was their oyster shell, so to speak. But they were on a campus where the faculty was black and white. There was no distinction in color. People didn't think of color. They went everywhere. There was a one rule: since we live right on campus, they could not go in dormitories. No dormitories. If you're going to get a spanking, you get caught in the dormitory. But they played ball on campus. We had the big football field where the pharmacy, we were playing football. On weekends, I would hit balls to them when nobody was around. They played to watch football games. So they grew up in a community with no distinction of race. Understanding education was important. Everybody there knew who they were, and if they were about to do something wrong, they'd grab them. But they grew up all to be, well-mannered, but more than that, mature. Several of them, one in particular, probably more mature than his years, and he loved helping people. The ladies in particular, who used to clean the uniforms for basketball and football, we had a little place where he'd go sit down and spend time talking to them, doing errands for them. He spent most of his time in the art department with John Scott. He's John Scott's lawyer now. But he spent time in the art department, and he was more gregarious than anybody. And wound up working with Stevie Wonder for 2 years. Stevie Wonder still calls him. But he is, I say, an artist, so to speak. We didn't know anything that he could. He had a show in Georgetown when he was practicing in Washington. And Lionel Hampton, he was Lionel Hampton's lawyer for the last 10 years of Lionel's life. In fact, he handled a funeral about a month ago. But he loved this campus. The rest of them did too. So I couldn't have found a better place to have children, six children, five in particular. Had all the babysitters you ever wanted, you know. Young ladies who wanted to get out to the dormitory could come when we had to go out and the like. So it became another kind of a home setting. And that was all through my time as Dean of Man Development, and then, of course, as an executive vice president. And then in 68, I was named president of the university. So that became a whole new dimension. And I lived on campus as president for about 8 years. And people say, I had a president's house. No, the house of the president where the house the president lived. It was nothing fancy. The same house I lived in was Adina Men was the same house I lived in when I was a president. And any quote entertaining we did, you know, we did in the student center and on campus. The camp.